First problem, find the position of the following points with respect to the parabola y square is equal to 6. Given points are 6, minus 6, 0, 1, 2, 3. So here the given problem is find the position of the following points with respect to the parabola. So means we want to tell whether the given point lies on the parabola or inside of the parabola or outside of the parabola. Already in the last video we discussed about these conditions, that is if S11 value equals to 0, then the point lies on the parabola. And if the value of S11 less than 0, then the point lies inside of the parabola. And the value of S11 greater than 0, then the point lies outside of the parabola. These are all the conditions. So first we are writing the given parabola as given parabola is S is equals to y square minus 6x. So we are taking the given parabola as yes, that is S is equal to y square minus 6x is equal to 0. And given points, first case, first point 6 comma minus 6. Now first we are substituting this point in the given equation. That is S11 is equals to y1 square minus 6x1. See, so here x1 y1 is equal to 6 comma minus 6. We take this point is equals to x1 y1. So S11 notation y1 square minus 6x1. y1 square, what is y1 square? Minus 6 whole square. Minus 6 whole square minus 6x1. x1 is equal to 6. That is 36 minus 36 equal to 0. Therefore S11 equal to 0. So the point 6 comma minus 6 lies on the parabola. Lies on y square is equal to 6x. Now coming to the second problem. The point is 0 comma 1. This is taken as x1 y1. Here also we take S11 value first. S11 is equals to y1 square minus 6x1. Now replacing the values 1 square minus 6 into 0. 1 minus 0 equals to 1. 1 means this is greater than 0. That is S11 greater than 0. Therefore the point 0 comma 1 lies outside of the parabola. Therefore the point 0 comma 1 lies outside of the parabola. Y square is equals to 6x. Y square is equal to 6x. And the third sum, given point is 2, 3. So 2, 3, which is x1, y1, 2, 3, which is x1, y1, and the value of S11 is equal to y1 square minus 6x1, that is 3 square minus 6 into 2, 9 minus 12, that is minus 3, which is less than 0. So therefore, S11 less than 0, so the point 2, 3 lies inside of the parabola, inside of y square is equal to 6x. That's all. Find the coordinates of the points on the parabola y square is equal to 2x whose focal distance is 5/2. Find the coordinates of the points on the parabola. That is, this is the parabola, given parabola y square is equal to 2x. This is parabola y square is equal to 2x. Now find the coordinates of the point on the parabola whose focal distance is equals to 5/2. So this is the point x1, y1. Now we want to find the focal distance value. What is focal distance? Focal distance is nothing but the distance of the point from the focus, that is SP. And the formula for finding the focal distance is x1 plus y. So this is the formula for finding the focal distance. So given that focal distance is equal to 5/2, that is x1 plus y is equal to 5/2. Find the coordinates of the points on the parabola. That is, we want to find the point P x comma y. So we want to find the coordinates of the point x comma y. Given that x plus y is equal to focal distance, x plus y. Given that x plus y is equal to 5/2. So here, first we are taking the given parabola. Given parabola is y square is equals to 2x. Now compare with y square is equals to 4a. Then we get the value 4a is equals to 2. 4a equals to 2. Then the value of a is equals to 2/4. That equals to 1/2. This is a value. What is given? Given that focal distance is equal to 5/2. Given that is equal to 5/2. What is focal distance formula? X plus y. X plus y is equals to 5/2. And a value 1/2. X plus 1/2 is equals to 5/2. Then the value of x is equals to 5a2 minus 1 by 2, that is 5 minus 1 by 2, 4 by 2 equals to 2. Now this is the value of x. Now we are substituting this value x is equal to 2 in the given parabola equation. Y square is equals to 2x, y square is equals to 2 into 2 equals to 4. Then the value of y is equals to plus or minus 2. Therefore the required points are points equals to 2 comma plus or minus 2. That's all. This is the required answer. Now the first two lines are the formulas which are used to find the equation of the parabola. The first formula is the equation of the parabola having its axis parallel to x-axis is x is equal to ly square plus my plus n. And the second formula, the equation of the parabola having its axis parallel to y-axis is y is equal to lx square plus mx plus n. Now these are the formulas. Here the given problem. Next, the equation of the parabola passing through the points minus 1 comma 2, 1 comma minus 1 and 2 comma 1 and having its axis parallel to x-axis. So find the equation of the parabola. We have to find the equation of the parabola. Given condition is having its axis parallel to x-axis. So having its axis parallel to x-axis means the formula is x is equal to ly square plus my plus n. That is the formula. In that formula, we are substituting the given points. And then we get three equations. By solving the three equations, we can get the values of L, M, N. And after replacing the values of the L, M, N in that equation, then we get the required answer. That is the procedure. So first, we take the formula x is equal to ly square plus my plus n. And in that formula, we have the points one by one in that equation. After getting the three equations, we will solve those equations. That is the procedure. So first we are writing the given points here. Given points are minus 1 comma 2, 1 comma minus 1 and 2 comma 1. Next we are writing the formula. The equation of the parabola having its axis parallel to x-axis is x is equals to L y square plus M y plus N. Now in this equation we are substituting the given points one by one. So first we are replacing the first point. Since it passes through minus 1 comma 2. So taking minus 1 comma 4 in this equation, that is minus 1 is equals to L into y square 2 square 4 plus m into y 2 plus n. That is, the first equation is 4l plus 2m plus n is equals to minus 1. Take say equation 1. And next one, since it passes through one comma minus 1, that is replacing that point in the above equation. 1 is equals to, x is equals to, 1 is equal to n into y square minus 1 whole square, that is 1, plus m into minus 1 plus n, that is n minus n plus n is equals to 1. Say equation 2. Now replacing the third point, since it passes through 2 comma 1. Now replacing the point 2 comma 1, so x is equal to, that is 2 is equals to l into y square 1 square 1 plus m into 1 plus n, that is l plus m plus n is equals to 2. So third equation. Of the three equations, first we take the first and second equations, 4l plus 2m plus n is equal to minus 1, and we multiply the second equation by 2, then we get 2l minus 2m plus 2n is equal to 2. Now here plus 2m minus 2m gets cancelled, so the remaining value 6l plus 3m is equals to 1. So equation 4. And here taking the second and third equations, minus m plus m gets cancelled. Now this is 2l plus 2n is equal to 3. So fifth equation. Now solving of these two equations, so here we have 6L and here we have 2L. So multiplying the fifth equation by 3 to get the value 6L. So this is 6L plus 3N is equals to 1. This is the fourth equation. And 6L plus 6N is equal to 9. This is the fifth equation into 3. We are multiplying the fifth equation by 3. Here we change the signs of the second equation like that. Now these two terms gets cancelled. 3n minus 6n is equal to minus 3n. Minus 3n is equals to minus 8. And the value of n is equals to 8 by 3. Now this is the value of n. Now replacing this n value in the fifth equation. From equation 5 we have, that 2n plus 2n is equal to 3. Now replacing the n value, 2n plus 2 into 8 by 3 equals to 3. That is 2n is equals to 3 minus 16 by 3. That is 9 minus 16 by 3 is equals to minus 7 by 3. Now this is 2n value. Then the value of n is equals to minus 7 by 6. From equation 3, we have that n plus n is equals to 2. That is n value minus 7 by 6 plus n value 8 by 3 equals to 2. That is the value of n is equals to 2 plus 7 by 6 minus 8 by 3. Writing these two terms to that side, which is equals to taking 6 LCM here. Take 6 to the 12 plus 7 minus. Now it is cancelled by 2 times 2 into 8, 16. That is 19 minus 16, 3 by 6 is equals to 1 by 2. Now we are replacing these three values in the equation x is equals to l y square plus m y plus n. Now we are substituting the values here in this equation. Therefore x is equals to l value minus 7 by 6 into y square plus m value 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into y plus 8 by 3. That's all. This is the required answer.